Salsa is a sauce used to add flavor to food. But who was the first to use the word salsa as a label for this Afro-Latin music? Well, it depends on who you ask, and there are a lot of theories on the issue with no clear answer. For example, some believe that it started in the mid-1960s with Fidias Danilo Escalona, a radio DJ from Venezuela who was known for his mustache. He had a radio show called La Hora de la Salsa, El Sabor y el Bembé. Some have said that he may have initially gotten the idea to include the name salsa in the program title while eating lunch with friends. Later on, Fidias reportedly interviewed New Yorican singers Richie Ray and Bobby Cruz, who described their music as ketchup or salsa de tomate in Spanish, and this is how supposedly the idea of salsa as a label was born. In fact, in 1966, the Venezuelan group Federico y su Combo released an album called Llegó la Salsa, but not so fast, because the word salsa has an even longer history when it comes to this music. For example, in the year 1966, Ray Barreto released a song called Salsa y Dulzura. But even before that, in 1963, New Yorican musician Charlie Palmieri released an album called Salsa Nama. And also in the same year, New Yorican group The Joe Cuba Sextet released the song Salsa y Bembé. Even before that, in 1957, the Cuban group La Sonora Habanera released an album called Salsa. And in the 1950s and the 1940s, many Cuban musicians such as Israel Cachao López, who is one of the pioneers of the Mambo rhythm, and also singer Benny More, and many others frequently used the word salsa as a way of indicating the flavor, energy, and excitement of the music. In fact, in the year 1933, Ignacio Piñero, pioneer of the Cuban son, had a song called Échale Salsita, which was apparently about adding flavor to food. So, to sum it up, while the word salsa was sometimes used in the context of food, at other times, it was used by musicians as an exclamation to describe the excitement of the flavorful music and dancing, similar to the use of other words commonly heard in many salsa songs such as sabor, azúcar, and saoco. But these uses of the word salsa were like little seeds that fertilized and prepared the musical world for the larger role that the term salsa would eventually play. As a result, in the early 1970s, the graphic artist and publisher for Fania Records, Izzy Sanabria, popularized the term salsa as the official label or umbrella term for this group of Afro-Caribbean rhythms. In fact, in the year 1974, New York City's Larry Harlow released an album for Fania Records called Salsa, and now it was official. This family of Afro-Caribbean rhythms mixed with jazz had one simple name, salsa, and the world hasn't been the same since. So, the bottom line is that no single person invented the word salsa out of the blue. Rather, many people contributed over time, and it seems that the term salsa first referred to a condiment that added flavor to food, but then, little by little, the word began to be used as a way to refer to the flavorful rhythms in dancing, and this set the stage for it to eventually be used as a label for this flavorful music, thereby putting all these different musical ingredients under one roof. So, if you enjoyed the information in this video so far, please hit like and leave a comment below, and be sure to subscribe for more innovative salsa music and dance concepts. So until next time, stay safe, stay connected to the music, and above all, keep dancing salsa.